Hello and welcome to another week of Chess Openings with me, Zach Sligowski, as we go over all the main openings that you can learn as a beginning chess player. This week we're going over the Trompowski opening, which is a d4 pawn opening that you can execute when the black player moves its knight to f6. So to start the Trompowski, all you need to do is move your pawn to d4, and black needs to move their knight to f6. If they don't move their knight to f6, there's nothing you can really do. You can't use the Trompowski. So from here, the next move for white to do is always bishop to g5, putting pressure on this knight. Now, there are a myriad of different ways that black can respond, and we'll go over all the main lines that you can see as you run the Trompowski. The first is the most common that you will see is when they move their knight to e4. Instead of losing this bishop here on g5, we're gonna wanna push it back to an f4, similar to the London. Most of the time, they'll try to reinforce this knight with a d5 pawn. We go and attack the knight with our pawn, kicking it back out to f6. We then push our pawn up with an e4 attack. They then take, we continue developing with our knight. They then take our pawn again, and we move up the knight to f3. We lose two pawns, but in return, we get great development here, getting three pieces of development compared to black's just one knight. So that is the main line that you will see most with the Trompowski. There are a couple other aspects that you will see as well. So we go into the Trompowski here. Another very common and probably the second most common one I saw when I played this is the d5 pawn opening. And in this case, you just take the knight, compromising his pawn structure. Now, the most likely thing that's gonna happen is the pawn will actually take from e7 to f6 instead of the g7 to f6 pawn like we see here. But this does double up the pawn structure here, creating some future problems for black as they move forward. We then continue our development, pushing the pawn up. Now that the bishop's gone, there's nothing blocking it in. Black will respond with a c5 pawn opening in the best of lines. You'll want to take, they take the middle, and what we lose in the center, we gain in this double up pawn structure here, putting us in about even going forward. Now, the other line that they can take is we go to the Trompowski and they push this e6 pawn up, opening the queen to protect this knight. Where we're gonna wanna get to go here is to take the center with a double pawn. They're not gonna take this pawn because it opens up the queen here. They'll then wanna kick out our knight here. We go ahead and take the bishop. They'll then take the bishop, and we continue our development here. Another variation that you might come across with the Trompowski is a aggressive c5 pawn. In this variation, you still take the knight, creating that double pawn structure, and then push up the pawn. By doing this, you take up the center for yourself. They'll try to create some sort of an attack. We would want to move the queen here, opening up this route here, and push up the pawns to protect this center structure that we have. And finally, the last most likely variation that you'll see out of all of these is when you go g6. You don't see this very often, but when you do, you again want to take that pawn, double up the pawn structure, develop the pawns. They'll push up the bishop to g7, hoping to get this castle. From there, it's all about the middle game and end game and how good you are as a player. But the Trompowski is very good at confusing your opponents and putting them in uncomfortable positions. If you like that video, please like and subscribe to the YouTube channel. I post here every week a new opening. Next week, we're going to go over the dragon variation. You can also find me at twitch.tv/ZachSligowski, where I play these openings every week and play with viewers like yourself to learn these openings and better educate new players like you and myself on how to use them. So I hope you have a great day and goodbye. Ah, why can't I figure out a good ending?